Mecha 03, Component 3. 4 Stirling engines in 2 configurations. Hello and welcome to a brief introduction to Mecha 03, a hypothetical vehicle based on ancient designs of the Shikuna Vimana aircraft. Long misunderstood as just a clumsy airplane, the Shikuna Vimana is actually an electric aircraft of ingenious design. Furthermore and most remarkably, Shikuna components and engineering knowledge seemingly did not exist until modern times. Using detailed and informed analysis, we now understand that the driving force of the Shikuna Vimana is electrification. The Shikuna Vimana is electrified using steam, and the steam flows continuously using 4 flywheels shown on both sides of the craft. Apparently, the heaters blow steam and air into the mast to create electrification, but air is fed to the heaters using 4 engines, which turn the pump shafts and move air through the system. The 4 engines that turn the pump shafts are known as Stirling engines. During the late 17th and early 18th century, steam engines were used for industrial purposes like mining. However, nearly 100 years later, the Stirling engine was invented, which has several advantages over steam engines. 1. Stirling engines use external combustion and they can transfer heat throughout the system. 2. Stirling engines have a regenerative heat engine, meaning that thermodynamic fluids are permanently contained and recycled without loss. And 3, Stirling engines are also called temperature difference engines, meaning they operate from temperature gradients. Therefore, Stirling engines can work at much lower temperatures than steam engines as long as temperature gradients exist. In the Shikuna schematic, a pipe connection can be clearly seen between the 2 sets of engines. The reasonable answer to why both engines are connected is, gaseous fluid flows back and forth between 2 chambers in a heat exchanger. A heat exchanger of this sort is called a regenerator. However, unlike steam engines which use steam energy, Stirling engines are difference engines. That means they operate from small variations in fluid temperature. Due to the small variations and lower operating temperatures, Stirling engines are considered to be more efficient. As described in previous videos, the heaters on both sides of the Shikuna Vimana may heat the flowing air, but they also radiate heat to all nearby surfaces. That means, all metal surfaces near the heater are affected, including the Stirling engine piston chambers. The heater may get very hot, but Stirling engines only need small heat gradients to operate, rather than perpetual steam temperatures. If the Shikuna Vimana is electrified, then electricity can feed subsystems like the heater coils. The 4 Stirling engines operate on thermal energy, emanating from the heaters. That is why the pistons sit on stands that run beneath the heaters. Ingeniously, heaters transfer heat to the Stirling engines using thermal radiation. Moist air inside the tube alternately heats and cools between pistons. The air inside continuously expands, contracts, and then recycles automatically. We have shown that the Shikuna Vimana likely uses 3 types of energy: electrical, mechanical, and thermal energy. The Stirling engine is yet another remarkable discovery that leads to many other incredible features easily identified in the Shikuna Vimana. To this day, few if any inventions utilize reciprocating engines like the paired Stirling engine, except perhaps the Shikuna Vimana. It is unknown who designed the pairs of Stirling engines in the Shikuna Vimana, because they were not invented until 1816 by Robert Stirling. Today, Stirling engines are still interesting as renewable energy devices.